Today, we're going to talk about unconscious biases, and guess what? We all have them. Stay tuned. So the definition of a bias is a feeling that we have against a person or a group. It's an unconscious feeling for many of us. And to be honest with you, I didn't think I had any biases. I have been working with all kinds of people for 20 years, and I felt like I had shed most of those biases. But here's what happened. I fly a lot, and I was on a plane just a few months ago, and a woman came on. She introduced herself as the pilot, and I sat there, and I went, yes, women! Women are the pilot! I was so excited that we had a female pilot, and I felt empowered. And then we started going through some turbulence, and they asked us to put our seatbelt on, and then it got really, really bumpy. And I actually turned to the person in the middle seat, and I said, I hope there's a guy back there with her. Do you believe it? There I am, exposing my bias. And so I think about biases a lot. I think that we think that we're bias-free, but we all have them. So I thought today what I would do is kind of explore why we have the biases and what really it is that we're connecting to. Number one, we connect to people who have the same background as we do. People who were maybe raised in the same part of the country or the world, we connect to them. Number two, culture. You know, I'm Italian. I love to go into stores that sell Italian foods and maybe be with a few Italian people. I connect to people who have the same culture as me. We connect to people who have the same personal experiences. Maybe people who work in the same line of work that we do or travel to the places that we enjoy. And we have social stereotypes. We think that we're one way and other social groups are another way. And all of this feeds into our biases, right? So I thought what I would do today is, number one, we have to explore and examine our own biases. But I want to give you a checklist. I want to give you a few things to think about that may be actually adding to a bias that you have. Number one is that like me theory. The like me theory is, I like to be around people like me. When I go to events, I hang out with people I know. When I'm picking my team, I just love to have three or four people on the team that are just like me, that think just like me. Because wouldn't life be great if I was just around people who were just like me? That like me theory, we have to think about a lot and we have to break through it. We have to be curious about other people and we have to add people who are different than we are into our group. I know that for a fact, because in 2010, I met a woman named Crystal Washington. Crystal and I look totally different. We are in two different generations, and her whole perspective on life is totally different than mine. She is totally about technology, and I was about writing everything down. Crystal and I worked together, and we joined forces. She wanted to become a speaker, and I wanted to learn about technology and social media, and we both mentored each other, and we co-mentored each other, and Crystal opened my eyes to the benefits of working and learning from people who are totally different than we are. The second thing we have to do is we have to stop feeding ourselves with the same data, with the same information. We have to stop watching the same TV shows, the same news programs. We have to stop reading the same magazines and newspaper articles and blogs and posts that really feed into who we are and our biases. And the third thing on the bias checklist is an interesting one. I want you to think about, it's called an anchor, and I want you to think about when someone introduces you to someone and they label them. I'd like you to meet Tom. He is a great retailer. He is a great marketer. He's a great something. We then see this person as only this for a long time. It also works in the negative. If somebody is talking to you about someone and they say something negative about them, it stays with you. It's a bias that you haven't even discovered on your own. This is called an anchor. An anchor is when you get information about someone and it really comes from someone else. And you anchor into that belief because someone's told you about it. So be careful what it is that you hear and think about other people. So here are three things that you can do to really help really control those biases. Number one is your awareness. I want you to begin to reflect on some of the things, some of the ideas that you think about certain people and where actually does that information come from? Is this bias really true? Number two, I want you to think about triggers, okay? When is it that you get angry with people that are different than you? Maybe when you're driving, maybe when someone's cut you off, maybe in the grocery store. Think about where you are when you have that little voice inside of you that's actually putting someone down. And the last thing I want you to do is when you feel, when you're aware of your bias, when your mind is saying something negative, just like with me, like, where is the male pilot on this flight? I want you to take a breath. I want you to take three breaths and I want you to slow down. Because when we become aware of our biases, we can begin to put them to sleep. So this is Karen McCullough with another lesson from the road.